Hello guys, welcome back to Techdose, and in this video we will see the stock span problem, which is kind of a financial problem. So let us look at the problem statement. Let us assume that we want to monitor a stock and the prices of the stock goes up and goes down, that is keep fluctuating each and every day. So we want to monitor a stock, and given that daily price of a stock is already mentioned till the current day. So let us assume that we are currently on day 7. So the prices from day 0 to day 6 are already given, as I have mentioned in the example. Now what are we required to find? We are required to find the span on each day from day 0 to day 6. So the prices from day 0 to day 6 have been mentioned, and I have drawn a rough histogram about it so that you can get a better understanding. Now what is a span? A span is nothing but it is maximum number of consecutive days before the ith day, such that the price is less than equals to the price on ith day. So let us assume that I want to find the span on day 5 in this given example. So on day 5 you can see that price on ith day, which is price on day 5, is 75. Now what will be the span? The span will be, I will keep moving to the left hand side, that is keep moving to the past days, and there I will see the consecutive days and compare with the price of the ith day. So as you can see, the price on day 4 is less than the price on day 5. So I will move to this day. I will include this in our span. Now the price on day 3 is also less than the price on day 5. So I will also include this day 3 in our span of day 5. Now as we can see, the price on day 2 is 60 and price on day 5 is 75. Now 2 is also lower, so I will include it in our span. Now as we compare this price on day 1 with day 5, then day 1 price is greater than day 5, so I will not include it in our span. So this is the span which we found for day 5. As you can see here, this is the maximum number of consecutive days which is starting from this day 5, such that the prices are always less than the price on the ith day, that is on day 5. So the span of day 5 will be 5 minus 2 plus 1, which will be equals to 4. Now you should always remember the constraints. The first constraint is that the days should always be consecutive. The second is that the days should always be adjacent to the day we are asked to find the span. So if we are finding the span for day 5, then the days should be attached, that is the days should be, the consecutive days should be adjacent to day 5. As in this example, the days were 2, 3, 4 and 5. These days are adjacent to 5. We cannot include 0, 1, 2, 3 and 5 even if it was possible, because there is a gap and so they are not adjacent. So we should always include the days adjacent to day 5, and all the days should be on the left hand side and the days should be consecutive. Now what is the simple approach to solve this problem? I have already written this problem. These are the days number and we have the price array, and we are required to find the span. Now how can we do it? The span for the first day, that is day 0, will always be equals to 1, since there are no days to the left hand side, and so this will form a span of size 1. And by the way, the span of size 1 is the lowest possible span size, because an element will include itself always. Now we will start from this day 1. When we are at day 1, then we can see that we will scan to all the elements on the left hand side. So as you can see that the day 0 price is greater than day 1, so I cannot include this day 0, so the span size will be 1. Now I will move to this day 2. The price is 60. Now when we are at day 2, then I will scan to the left hand side, and when I move to left hand side on day 1, the price is greater than day 2, so I will not include this day 1, so the span size here is also 1. Now I'll move to day 3. Now when I am at day 3, the price is 70, so I will scan the left hand side. So the price on day 2 is 60, which is lower than the day 3 price, so I'll include it in span of 3. Now I'll move to the next element, which is day 1. Day 1 price is 80, which is greater than the price on day 3. So I will not include it. Therefore, the span size of this day 3 is 2, which is including this day 2 and day 3. So it will be of size 2. Now I'll move on to the next day, which is day 4. Now day 4 price is 60, and so I will scan the left hand side. The price on day 3 is 70, which is greater than 60, so I will not include it, and therefore the span size here is 1. And similarly, when I scan this day 5, then you can see that we can include this 4 because price on day 4 is lower than price on day 5. Similarly, we can include this day 3, we can include this day 2, but we cannot include this day 1. So we will stop at day 2. So the span size of this 5 will be 2, 3, 4, 5. So it will be equals to 4. Now we will move to 85. Now you can see that from this day 6, we can include this day 5 because the price of day 5 is less than equals to the price on day 6. Similarly, we can include day 4, day 3, day 2 and day 1, but we cannot include this day 0. So we will stop till day 1 and we will include this in the span of day 6. So this will be of size 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. So this is of size 6. Now what is the time complexity of this simple approach? In this simple approach, if we are given the prices in ascending order, then the worst case time will go to order of n square. How? Because for the first element, we will be just checking the first element. For the second element, we will be checking these two elements. For the third element, we will be checking all these elements. For the fourth element, we will be checking all these elements. So the time will be 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus and so on till n, which will be equals to n into n plus 1 by 2, which is order of n square. And the space complexity will be On, because that will be required for the span array. Now how can we reduce this time complexity? Actually, we are getting this high time complexity because we are traversing back again and again and we are checking the same element again and again. But what if we can maintain the stock prices in decreasing order so that we don't have to check each and every element again and again? So for that reason, we will maintain a stack, and the efficient approach makes use of a stack, and this will reduce our time complexity from On square to just On. So let us look at the efficient approach now. So this is the algorithm for the efficient approach. I will explain it on the left hand side and you can refer the algorithm meanwhile so that you will get a better understanding. So as you can see, we are given the days, we are given the price array, and we are required to find the span. Now in order to find the span efficiently, we will take a stack and the stack name will be S. We will push the first day, which is day 0, into the stack, and then what we will do is we will iterate for all the other days. So for the first day, as you already know, that the answer will be equals to 1 because there are no elements to the left hand side, and therefore it will be the span of size 1 because one element is a span of size 1, and I already told you that the minimum span size will be 1. There will be no span lower than 1. Now we will start from day 1. When we are at day 1, then we will check with the top of the stack. Now as you can see here, it's a while loop. If the stack is not empty and the top element is less than equals to the price at the ith day, then we will keep popping the elements because we want to maintain the elements in decreasing order in the stack. But as you can see that the 0th day element is greater than the ith day, which is the first day element, so we won't do anything. Now the second condition is that we are checking if the stack is empty, because if the stack is empty, then the span size will be I plus 1 simply. But if the stack is not empty, then the span size will be I minus the top of the stack. Actually, the stack is storing the days. It is storing the day number. So when we are at the ith day and we already know that the top of the stack is greater than this ith day price, so the span size will be the ith day minus the top of the stack. In this case, it will be 1 minus 0, which will be equals to 1. So here span size will be 1. Now we will just push this ith day, which is day 1 into the stack, and we will move on to the next day. The next day is day 2. On this day you can see that the price is 60, and so we cannot pop any of the elements from the stack, since the top of the stack is having the price greater than the ith day price. So no elements will be popped. Now the second thing will be checked, that the stack is empty. No, it's not empty. So we will move on to the else part, and in the else part the span size will be the ith day, which is 2, minus the top of the stack, which is 1, which will be equals to 1. So span will be 1 here, and we will push the ith day, which will be 2, into the stack. Now we will move on to the next day. The next day price is 70. Now again the while loop will run, and in this case we can see that the top of the stack is 2, and the price on day 2 is lower than the price on day 3. So we will pop this, pop the top of the stack. Now we will move on to the day 1. On day 1 the price of the stock is greater than the price on day 3. So we won't do anything. Now we will check if the stack is empty. Stack is not empty. So the span will be equals to this ith day minus the top of the stack, which will be equals to 3 minus 1, and span size will come out to be 2. Now we will push this day 3 into the stack, and then we will move on to the next day, which is day 4. Here you can see that the price is 60 and the top of the stack is having price 70. On day 3 we have price 70. So we won't pop anything. Now the stack is also not empty. So the span size will be equals to I minus S at top. So I is this 4. So 4 minus 3 will be equals to 1. So here span size will be 1. And we will push the ith day, which is day 4, and move on to the next element. The next day, on day 5, we have price as 75. So we will keep popping all the days till we reach a day so that the price on that day is greater than 75. So you can see that day 4 is having a price of 60. So we will pop it. Day 3 is having a price of 70, so we will pop it, but the next top element is 1, and the price on day 1 is 80, which is greater than the price on day 5, so we will stop there. Now we will check if the stack is empty. Stack is not empty, so the span size will be ith day, that is 5, minus the s at top, that is the top of the stack, which is 1, which will be equals to 4, so here you will have the span size of 4. Now we will push this ith day into the stack, and we will move on to the next element, which is 85. Now when we are at day 6, then we will check for all the elements. So you can see that the day 5 element is having a price lower than the day 6 element. So we will pop it, and then we will check with the day 1 element. On day 1 the price of the stock was 80, which is lower than what it was on day 6. So we will pop it again, but on day 0 the price of the stock is greater than day 6, so we won't pop, and so our while loop will break here. Now we will check if the stack is empty. Stack is not empty, so our span size will be this ith day, which is 6, minus top of the stack, which is 0, so span size will come out to be 6 here. Now we will push this day 6 into the stack. Now all the elements have finished in the array, and so the span array has already been found here, as you can see. Now let us analyze the time complexity of this algorithm. So in the worst case, if you are given the worst case, that is elements in increasing order, then maximum you will have to traverse each of the element twice. So in this case the time complexity will be order of 2n, which will be equals to order of n. You can take an example and solve it so that you will get a better understanding. Now what will be the space complexity? The space complexity will be order of n because of the extra space required to find the span. So I hope you understood this stock span problem. As always, the code will be present in the description section below, so you can check it out. If you face any type of problem, then do comment below and I'll try to help you as soon as possible. Like and share our video and subscribe to our channel in order to watch more of these programming videos. See you in our next video. Thank you.